God, look at that level 13 kid.
Oh my god.
I was so close to everybody in levels.
Now you're not.
Now you're not, kid. We got to bully you because you're a year younger than us.
Fuck, that's too real.
Hello.
Hello. Alright, I got a bunch of gems. Got some war knuckles, too.
Better not take my war knuckles.
Hey, Kreno, teleport to me.
Alright.
Wow.
Alright, we're back in action.
How fast did you jog, Eric?
Well, you know, jogging is an understatement. I ran jog.
You ran. You're not out of breath. You don't sound very out of breath.
There's another end to this cave. I think we should explore it before we...
I drove.
Okay, let's follow Sam. You drove? Oh.
Yeah.
I'm just out of gas, not breath.
I am out of gas. I'm gassed. Physically, mentally, emotionally.
Emotionally. Physically. And also, you know, gastrointestinally. You know, so
and gastrointestinally. Especially gastrointestinally.
Yeah. We got a boomer.
We got a baby boomer here.
Oh, all right,
Let's wait for Slowpoke.
It had a way.
We should play Left 4 Dead one time. That'd be hilarious with us four.
Oh, yeah, we should.
It's like a perfect game for it.
Yeah.
It's like £2 as well.
Did Krendor run to his office? No, I drove to it.
No, he ran. He's just being humble. Cardiovascular king.
Come, Shadowfax!
Show us the meaning of speed.
Show us the meaning of haste.
Oh, fuck.
Oh my god, you got wrecked.
Wow. How do you feel about that? How do you feel about
that? Wait. I'm pretty sure it's show us the meaning of speed in the movies.
Show us the meaning of haste.
Oh, fuck.
You're the one that, you watch Lord of the Rings every week. You still don't know the lines.
I watched embarrassing. The films.
Fucking like, embarrassing.
And I realize entirely why I feel the way I do about it.
Why?
Because it's garbage and I hate it. It's just silly decisions that add up over time.
Yeah.
Like, it's not end of the world shit, but it's too shit for what it could have been. A nice simple
about how they fucked it up?
Yeah, I mean, just stretching out a book smaller than the other one. Like, the other one's a trilogy and this is a single book.
Fuck yeah. Man. Like, I like the first Hobbit movie.
It was alright.
The second one, it was like, I got bored kind of halfway through.
Yeah.
And then the third one, I was like, eh. Like, I feel like it even could have been two movies. Like, two would have been fine.
It would have been better.
Yeah.
But like, there was a lot of time just spent.
Wait, how do we open this fucking room?
Also, fuck me, was Thorin like a bipolar girlfriend, you know? Like, he was just like, you're not one of us, so fucking hate you. And then like 5 minutes later, he's like, I love you, Bilbo, I'll suck your dick. And then he fucking 5 minutes later again, suddenly he's like, you're not a dwarf, you're a fucking hobbit. Bullshit. And I hate it. And I can never trust him in the film.
Yeah,
it's true. Trust is earned, and he didn't earn our trust.
No, he constantly played with it. Because he's the son of a fucking king, are you kidding me? Now that's some poopy garbage, if you ask me.
Shadow Ronin 45 dropping 100 bits. S. Sam, did he ever pick up the Draino?
What's the Draino? Oh, the thing that you're gonna put in the sink.
Yeah. How's the sink doing, Sam?
So, what actually caused it was because like I live
demons.
In an apart, because I live in like an apartment building. The two flats are like directly above me. Have a sink in the same place and share the same like pipe down to the mains, and they like basically blocked their pipe, so all the dirty water from the three flats.
I can't open this.
From the sinks was like just getting rerouted out of my sink, like from all the sinks above me.
Yeah.
So Draino wouldn't have done shit.
What kind of water was it? Was it like shit water?
There was like leaves and dirt in it. Someone above us was a gardener, and they like blocked the sink and fucked our apartment. when I find out.
Pay a little visit.
Hey, I hear you like gardening.
Just pull out like a fucking hoe.
Get
shit.
Grab some shears and just like snip their dick off.
Just like fucking rev the chainsaw. and then start trimming their verge and just be really handy. And then be like a good neighbor. And just, you know, be a cool guy. And then they won't do it again. That's the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, happy solutions.
Yeah.
Oh, I got a legendary. And then you chop his head off with a chainsaw.
Classic neighbors, dude.
That's when good neighbors become
good friends.
Oh.
Whoa.
Dude, I fucking hate EastEnders. I always have. But neighbors, I used to watch that as a kid. I was just like, wow, they're good neighbors. These are great neighbors. I loved it.
I don't think I've ever seen that show.
They weren't great. They weren't like great. All right,
so Neighbors is the Australian soap, Eric.
We're going back to the door.
Also had Home and Away, which was another gem, if I do say so myself.
Yeah. Wasn't Neighbours the Australian one?
Yeah, they're both Australian. Home and Away and Neighbours.
Yeah. Huh. Artifact Tech. Resubbing 15 months in a row. Thanks, Artifact Tech. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Swag. Wait, so I'm still confused. What is it? It's a soap? What? Hold on.
I just can't.
What?
Where are you, Eric?
It, like, kicked me off Discord because it's like, you've connected at another location, which means the other internet came back on.
Oh. Uh-oh.
Well.
Oh, looks like Toast got the last laugh here.
And I just waited.
She's gonna log on my account.
She probably doesn't even know it's on. She's probably like on her phone.
Playing Diablo on the phone. I know that game.
D-phone
Dude,
Diablo.
You could literally, if Diablo had this graphics, you could literally play it on a phone.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, you could.
Play that on would the be Nintendo that Switch. Would be good times.
They're probably gonna announce it next BlizzCon.
We should find a fun mobile game that's multiplayer that we can all play as a group. You know.
Yeah.
You know, in our downtime of playing video games, so we can play some more video games together.
Yeah, that'd be great. I'd love to play video games with you guys. That sounds like a great idea.
Also, you could play with us in class, Ben. That's the bonus.
Yeah.
You don't need to study.
Well, I got legendary.
What? You don't need education.
What's the
thing is,
get
I pay attention in every class, and I attend every class. So, I write down 100% of what the lecturer says and writes on the board. Every single
what
lecture.
What a nerd.
But it's because I fucking suck at hearing. I'm like deaf. So I can't hear shit.
That isn't why.
Wait,
that
but then how
why.
Do you write it down if you can't hear what he's saying?
Yeah, if you can't hear it, how are you writing it down? I see loopholes in this story, Crendel. Yeah, how about you?
Alright, I'll show you the notes. Alright, I've got binders here. Okay, I'll show
are
you.
The notes just like you constantly assuming words with a question mark?
Yeah, that's the thing. Alright, that is the downside. Is that it's everything that's written on the
like,
board.
Bender?
And then like
question
they kind of
annotate. And then you have to like ask someone else and they're like, oh no, it was a Fender. And you're like,
that
oh.
happens all the time. Every day of my life. And I have to live with it. And I don't have a hearing aid. I'm just. Fender.
Arthritis in a hearing aid. Are you sure you're not just an old man?
I have so many fucking
And you're catfishing us?
Dude. Yes. That's true. I'm also wearing a cardigan, and I have a healthy stock of Weathers Originals, so I'm not too sure that's far from the truth.
Thanks.
That's true. Yeah, don't you like Weathers? Everyone
says
they
love them. I love them.
I think they're beautiful. Butter candy.
So, I plugged my phone into this charging cable, right? And after I did that, it started, like, freaking out.
Yeah.
Like, I was just going to, like, click on the thing. And it clicked on something completely random. And I was like, what about this? And then it did it again. So I think the charging cable somehow like goofed my phone. You know, it played a goof on it. It pranked it.
Fucking goofed my phone.
Oh,
bro.
Someone said to me, make sure we have cutscenes enabled in our settings. So we don't miss all the old school cutscenes.
I think I do.
I hate them.
How would I even do that?
Gameplay. Silly squirrels just subscribe. Big silly squirrels.
Cutscene play?
No,
Swag.
I lied.
Welcome.
Sorry, I'm half deaf. I can't hear you. Oh, shit. It might be in gameplay. Pick up.
It's not in video. and it's not in gameplay.
I think it's for sound. Hello, Tina.
Ruh-roh, Scooby-Dooby.
Ruh-roh, Scoob, that's my name.
Ruh-roh, Scoob, I think we have a dangerous bad man here. What? What? That's not your voice. Fuck, I can't...
I don't think that's a saying. I think someone just fucking lied.
Options. Why would the internet lie?
You really think people do that? Just go on the internet and lie?
That doesn't make any sense. There's cinematic subtitles.
I think it's okay.
Yeah, I think it's fine.
Yeah. We can probably act them out, like, in, I don't know, Pictionary or some shit on Tabletop Simulator. Oh, you've not played Tabletop with us, Sam, have you?
No.
Oh, that's true, he hasn't.
Oh, boy. He's in for a rigmarole.
You're in for a rigor mortis.
Oh, there it is. Automatically skippable cutscenes.
Oh, where is it?
It's in gameplay. On the right-hand side, it says automatically skippable cutscenes. You have to uncheck it.
Mine's unchecked.
Yeah, mine's unchecked.
Mine was checked.
Damn.
I was skipping everything.
Mine's Slovakian. I'll be here all week.
Watching cutscenes.
Yeah. Long-ass cutscenes.
Alright, so the internet is working again. But now I'm here, so... What are you gonna do?
Hello, everybody. Level 16. Sucking my poo. Ba-dip-ba-ba-ba-da-doo. God, I love it when you just have to sacrifice everything in your being for a lyric, just because you can't rhyme. Shit.
Tell you what, I can rhyme, I do it all the time.
Hey guys, you wanna pop in the, in the chamber of the bone?
Yeah, it's good. Oh! Get down there.
I thought a cutscene was gonna happen.
Fucking rappers are amazing to me. I don't, it's just, it's incredible. I guess it's practice, like, remembering words that rhyme together, but still.
Yeah.
Fuck me, it's incredible. It's credible. It's a credible source.
That's a credible source, dude.
I would support you if I was on your jury.
Yeah, dude. The Metal Forge, you'd require to, like, find a rhyming word within, like, seconds.
Milliseconds. Yeah, literally.
That also makes sense as well, like.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Does anyone else watch Judge Judy sometimes?
Yes.
Yes.
Fuck. I felt like, oh god! Get out of there! Don't go! That's a death trap, man.
Not gonna lie,
I
really do.
I'd like to open up to you guys about Judge Judy, because it's fucking hilarious, and I love it, even though it's fake.
Brendo, we're too scared. We're too scared.
Well, what they do is, like...
just the characters that are on it.
So many options.
Nobody loses money, they just pay them. And then if you win, you get some money too, but it's like, you don't lose anything by losing.
The thing is, they do kind of make them amp it up a bit.
Yeah.
But still, like, just... things that people like. Obviously, this is people's. Even if they're being told to amp it up, they're attempting to improv then, and these are just random people trying to improv.
Yeah.
It's really funny. And so she said, get the charger. And I was like, get the phone, get the charger. So I stole the phone. That, like, weird logic there.
Yeah. And she's like, what are you? Some sort of
moron?
She's
like, let me get that straight. You stole her phone?
I didn't steal her phone. You said you stole her phone. I didn't steal any phone.
Judge Judy's like the perfect matriarch of a family. She would like guide you to justice.
Justice?
Yeah, justice. She's a fucking Judy.
She makes you
right. She's a fucking judge. Nah, that's just a slip up there.
That's a little slip down the slope.
Down the slippery slope. Logical fallacy. Sam, I swear you take no damage compared to me.
What?
What's your build? Can you upload your build to DiabloBills.com, please?
Icy veins, please.
I just got shoulder pads.
Cool, okay. Nice. They suit your feminine figure.
Can I check on those pads?
Oh, dude, my item's behind a wall of shit. I can't get to it. Oh, there you go. don't just ignore that.
I mean, Judge Judy was an actual judge. I mean, she still probably is.
I think she was, yeah. She's a
She was like a juvenile court type judge.
She was in juvie, and that's when she decided to turn all around and become a TV show judge.
Yeah.
Fucking fantastic
career.
She was
just like, hey, quit being an idiot. You're 16. Get your life together. And that was like her
whole
thing.
How she has, yeah, she knows. She's been on the streets.
Yeah.
Right? She's
done the mean streets of Gotham.
I think she was like one of the first judge shows, actually. And now there's just a bunch of them.
Well, she's like...
Is there actually a bunch of them? I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, there's so many, and they're all got their little quirk things. It's like when Steve Wilkos branched off from Maury, you know?
Yeah.
He made the Steve Wilkos show, and it's just garbage. I mean, they're both garbage, but it's still just
nothing's,
garbage.
Nothing is true garbage like Maury. Like, you're not going to compete with Maury, dude. Maury is the one and only true garbage.
Do you know who Steve Wilkos is?
Actually, or no, it was Jerry Springer, I think you mean.
Jerry Springer is like... Oh yeah, it might be that one. They're kind of all the same trash though, right? But
Jerry
Springer is probably the worst.
Jerry Springer.
But yeah, no. Steve Wilkos was one of the fucking like bouncer people on that show. And then he went and made his own version of that show. So it's like, he has nothing but just like a fucking weird skinhead man's like going, you're stupid, right? I wouldn't have done that. I wouldn't have fucked her. That's not what I would have done. Alright, thanks Steve Wilkos.
They're like, woo!
Wilkos, wow, you're the man.
Steve!
Yeah, and then there's like the fucking sign telling them all to clap because you wouldn't know otherwise.
That's like how Oprah made Dr. Oz and Dr. Phil. She makes all the doctors become popular and they just branch off and do their own thing. So Oprah's like, we're bringing on Dr. Phil.
Dr. Phil is like really weird because like Dr. Phil here.
Dr. Phil, you're like a shoe without a shoelace. You just ain't done nothing right.
It's like the exact kind of shit he thinks up. It's weird.
Yeah.
Oh god!
Oh yeah, we need to watch out here. It's Bilefroth, the Bitmaster.
Yeah, it's like
see,
you watch him.
The Bitmaster, not the Bitmaster.
Oh, it's coming up on my
screen.
Guys,
if you want to be a Bitmaster, though, drop those bits.
Oh dude, wait! Wasn't that what they were called in Beyblade? They were Bitmasters?
Bitmasters.
The thing inside was called the Bitbeast, do you remember that?
Yeah.
Holy fuck. And then, and then you'd have Drazeel and Dragoon.
The Bitbeast, when the Bitbeast came out, they fucking fought.
Yo, I'm just saying, my brother had the main character that looked like Goku.
Look, all I'm saying is, Digimon Online is free to play on Steam. It came out recently. It's fucking garbage, but we could be Bitbeasts.
Listen,
Bitbeast
I'm saying is, oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
That's all I'm saying.
All I'm saying is, like, literally, oh my god.
My god, I feel like we all need to get
like
some Starbucks and sit down and play that game and just be like, oh my god, this pumpkin latte is divine.
This is my fight song, take back my life song.
Sadly, it's cold.
This is my take back my life song.
Oh my god, not again.
That's the lyrics.
Of that fucking song.
This is my fight song, take back my life song.
Yeah. You should imagine them like, nodding. No.
Yes, girl, take back your life!
Take back your life that you didn't have, because.
Yeah, as a middle class suburban white girl, you're so oppressed. You're so hard.
My life is the most difficult. Yesterday, my dad said he's gonna buy me shoes, then he didn't buy me shoes. I was like.
Instead, he bought me boots.
Now I have to wear the same boots as Jenny. This is.
You sound like the girl out of Bob's Burgers.
What's Bob's Burgers?
That's probably what they based it off of.
What's Bob's Burgers?
You need to go educate yourself a little bit.
TV show.
It's like a cartoon. Long running cartoon. It's kind of like The Simpsons, Family Guy. But like, I personally, I think it's got a shine that Family Guy will never have.
Well, Family Guy is derivative trash. So I tend to stay away from that kind of crap. But South Park's pretty good.
I liked it when I was like,
how can you call? All right, I'm not biting.
No, I'm not trolling. Simpsons, OG.
South Park is great, but it's definitely in the same vein as Family Guy.
All right, no. South Park does political, like it does topical things, right? And it does it with a very well done juxtaposition with the absolute ridiculous. Family Guy is literally shitty fucking callback jokes to the 80s that no one gets except for Seth MacFarlane, and they're trash.
That's true.
But South Park does have its bad episodes, yeah, I agree.
No, I never said that. I think South Park's amazing.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Family Guy to me is just I used to like it when I was a kid, but then I grew the fuck out of it.
Yeah.
South Park I can still respect.
That's what happened to me.
You're like, South Park I can still respect.
And you're like,
yeah, because you see what they're doing. My favorite episodes are the ones that aren't even political, you know? It's the ones where they're just kids being kids. I find them hilarious.
Yeah.
Because it so, like, rings true. Because the whole point of South Park is that kids are foul-mouthed and shit, because that's what actual kids are like.
Yeah.
People think that their kids are little angels, but really, as soon as they leave the house, they're like, fucking shit. Yeah.
Dude, I remember getting away from the car or, like, walking to school, and then just, like, fucking curse mode activates. And you're just swearing every other word.
Well, you're just, like, you're peer-pressured around other kids as well. So they're just like, yeah, you hate this fucking thing, and you're like, hey, yeah, fucking thing.
Yeah,
I'm cool.
That's a weird analogy, Crandall. Eat this dick. Yeah, eat this fucking dick. All right, I'm gonna eat this,
Yeah, but no kid's gonna say eat the dick.
Well, that's not true. I think that's like kids don't really understand the insults they're throwing.
Well, yeah, that's true. All right, never mind. I take back. Chaos Drakkery 73 months
ago. I remember
thanks,
eat
Chaos
a dick
Drakkery.
Being like a prolific childhood insult.
Yeah.
Swag. 3 months of sloth goodness. Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah, dude.
Sloths are pretty cute animals. What's your spirit animal, Eric? And you're not allowed to say sloth. Oh, there's golems. You're not allowed to say golems either.
Alright.
Any kind of mythical creature. It must be a real life creature.
It has to be. I don't know.
It must have four limbs or less. I don't accept arachnids. Sorry, it just creeps me out. Oh shit, that got hit hard.
Yeah, they hit pretty hard.
This is my fight song.
Mine
would be a fucking manatee. I love manatees. I think they're great, and I love that they grow moss on their backs.
I'd probably say
it's kind of like they're kind of like a traveling agent of history. You see turtle?
I at least used to be a turtle.
Like the Shucky Bra kind of turtle from Finding Nemo. It's like go to the flow, man.
Yeah,
Shucky Bra.
Yeah, he's like Shucky Bra, man.
Hold on, I gotta go sell my shit.
I am returning to town.
I don't think it's gonna sell for much, mate.
I just gotta clear it all out, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know that feeling. I got some shit you can take for that.
It's called, fiber. And it works a charm.
Really, man? Can I please borrow some?
Oh, Eric, I got a softie you might like.
Cool. Alright.
Another one, just in case you might like that one.
Alright, let me check. Despair, my love. No, they're garbage. I'm gonna sell them.
Excuse me?
Oh, shit! Well, I just sped through, I just disenchanted my cleaver.
Now look what you've done. Bet you feel like a rival.
It doesn't matter. Once you unlock the transmog, you have it for good.
Oh, okay. Never mind. I don't care anymore then.
That's pretty sweet. What's your spirit animal, Sam?
God, I don't know, man.
Turtle. And don't say lion because it's the king of the forest.
I used to think my spirit animal was a bear.
Oh shit. Okay. Can you elaborate? Can you explain?
Well, I really enjoy sleep and food.
Oh
and,
shit.
Like I'm pretty like alpha when I need to be, you know? Like I can get on my hind legs and fucking
do you like rubbing your back against
you're
trees?
You're a prime alpha male, ready to lead the pack.
I'm a big dude warfare. Too. I'm like 6'4", like 6'5". So I'm like a bear is like a good fit for me.
Oh, okay. I mean that I agree with everything you're saying, but do you like sticking your hand in honey pots? You know, like into the.
I enjoy honey too.
He enjoys honey. I don't have any rebuke. I mean, I have to just accept that you're a bear. Guess I'll be the otter.
Chat alpha in the sense of like, I'll fight for what's mine. Not like alpha in the fucking.
I'll fight for what's right because I'm a hero.
No, not for what's right. I'm if someone steps to me, I'll step back. Not like. Yo, thanks. I'm like an alpha dude. Like, I'm like a pickup expert.
Yo, so alpha bro here, coming at you with another video.
Not 4chan alpha. I'm saying alpha in the sense of like,
yeah, Yeah, yeah. Right. I know what you're saying.
I'll be pack lead. I'll pack lead. You know?
Yeah. You'll pack. Yeah, you're assertive.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm assertive.
Yes.
Like if someone upsets my friend, like I'll be the one that like gets in their face.
Oh shit. Well, Sam, I've got like 5 bullies. Every time I try and leave my house, there's these chavs that make fun of me.
On top of those, don't worry.
All right, thanks, man.
Taken care of. Already
appreciate
taken care
it.
Of.
Thanks, Sam.
First time I ever wore a turtleneck with long sleeves, it got caught on some wire grating outside my friend's house, and chavs laughed at me, and I nearly cried. I've never worn a turtleneck since.
That's fucking horrible.
It got like snagged on some fucking like chicken wire fence.
What? How does a turtleneck even get snagged on anything? What the fuck are you saying?
I was walking down this hill, and this is very vivid for me, you have to understand.
I'm trying to understand how it could happen.
Let's try harder, because you're making me feel pretty bad right now. It just feels like I'm reliving it.
Well, oh boy. You know.
Huh. JP's more of a panda, though.
Yeah, I can see that.
JP's more of a panda. I'm more of like a polar.
Because
I don't have any friends, so I'm quite the loner, which is another bear tree.
Why are we going backwards?
Oh, thanks, man. Say that in the presence of 2 people that consider your friends.
No, yeah. I'm just saying, like, I don't.
I'm just saying I don't actually care about it.
I don't have that many friends, man. That's all I'm saying, all right?
Okay, it's fine.
Snedry,
I'm like
Baloo
out of the Jungle Book.
Thank you, Snedry.
One of you is Mowgli, and one of you is Bagheera.
I totally understand.
Swag. Also, Snedge says, heart at Krendor, Benji scares me, though.
Benji, what's your animal? You never said.
My animal? I think I said manatee. But the thing about manatees, I like specific.
You said manatee, but you lied. You only said manatee because you like that they grow moss on their back. It has
I think that's real
connection
fucking
to you at all.
Well, that's the thing. I haven't tried to grow moss on myself, but I think I could if I tried. But at the moment, I'm going to probably not do that, considering it's fucking moss. But. Uh-oh.
That's the truth.
Whoever fucking released those health pots saved my dick. And I
holler
appreciate
at you, boy.
Holler at you. I think I could be. Let me think about it. What kind of animal could I be? What animal is like clinically slow enough to destroy itself?
Yeah, but you're also highly intelligent. So, like, you got to factor that in. Yeah, like, you're slow, but you're an orangutan. Fuck, you're an orangutan.
Yeah, I do have fucking huge man boobs, and I've got like orange hair in my beard.
And you're like old manish and slow, but really intelligent. You're an orangutan.
Fuck, I'm an orangutan. Shit, I never even thought of it like that.
Shit, dude.
Hey guys.
It's me.
It's the
I
movie.
Have
oh my god,
faces.
Oh god! Run!
Oh my god.
I do eat the faces
Jesus.
Of my enemies as well.
My HP.
Oh my
they
Jesus.
They can't get out the door.
Oh sweet. They're too big.
Tell
it's
you
perfect.
What, one time I ripped a man's face off. And I feel good about
oh fuck.
Yeah, aren't orangutans like very violent?
No, it's mostly chimps. Just regular old chimps.
Yeah, regular chimps.
About
because they flip out and they're smaller than us generally. But like a chimp is fucking so strong, dude. They will rip your arms off.
Jesus.
Yeah,
what about
don't fuck with chimps.
Baboon?
I don't know, like
baboons, right? What about baboons?
They would rip the arms off like a child, but like a strong human would fuck a chimp up, like scientific.
Chimps are deceptively strong. The reason why chimps and stuff are so strong for their size, Sam, is because
it's their density, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah, exactly. Because we developed a lot of our energy into our brains and stuff, and we sort of left behind muscle. How are gorillas and shit so fucking swole without like lifting weights? It's because their body naturally pumps a lot of its energy into their muscle mass, whereas we have to devote quite a lot to our brain.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, if fucking a chimp tried to fight, like, Terry Crews would fucking destroy that chimp.
Well, Terry Crews is a bodybuilder, which means he's great at isolation movements and maybe a couple compounds in there to lift
but,
and shit. But
the range of motion required to punch.
I don't know if he knows MMA, like... man. Like, yeah, I don't know if he can lift his arm that far back.
I don't know, I think I might bet on the chimp.
I would, nah, Terry Crews every day.
Chimps are fucking
tell
so
you what,
strong, dude.
This summer,
they're like, there's
HBO
a there's stories
of MMA,
grown,
Terry
man.
Crews versus the chimp.
Alright, rock it's the Dwayne Johnson against the chimp.
Well, I, yeah.
Depends on how trained the chimp is.
Yeah. No. What do you mean? What do you mean? You can't say depend. It's yes. It's like a you just pick one: the rock or chimp.
Well, is the rock like? Are we talking a specific time period rock, like 90s rock? Or are we talking now rock after?
We're talking now rock.
Okay, so post human growth hormone.
Now rock against the chimp.
He's like a fucking monster.
He would destroy a chimp. He would fucking like if the chimps like sent a fighter into battle and we sent the rock. The rock would come back like bloodied and victorious, wearing
chimps
fucking
are
chimp
powerful
skin.
For their size, Sam, but they're also fucking small, so they also have that dex. You know, they can climb around trees. They can climb around your body. That's like you're the trunk and they're the chimp. You know, they can scale you like a fucking tree in no time. And what's the rock gonna do when it's behind him and its hands are in
his
eyes?
Or when his face is ripped off?
Exactly.
His hands are in its eyes.
I call it its because the rock isn't technically considered human at this point. He's so much beyond.
Yeah, he is. You're right.
Uh-oh. Roll, Scooby. That was close.
Roll.
You saved me. Oh!
Ooh!
Oh! Ooh! He broke my legs.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. This is getting dangerous.
Am I just weak? I think I've got no tetanus.
No!
Alright, let me
you're
just
going too small. Legendary... I'm a little bit small. The rock's like 6'3".
Yeah, he's pretty fucking big. What about Shaq? What about Shaq, man?
Shaq's not strong though. He's just big.
Dude, Shaq's big, yeah, but you say that. But what's the argument I just gave? Is mobility? Shaq's got mobility. He could jump.
No, he hasn't. He's retired. He's a retired fat dude that plays video games.
You can create Shaq mobility. He's retired. I think he could scale a building.
On my street basketball team, I pick up Shaq. No doubt.
I'd pick up.
I'll take retired Shaq.
No doubt.
Over.
No doubt in my mind.
Shaq's a cool dude as well. He's got that going for him. He could actually diplomacy the chimp. You know, like, did you ever think of that? He could actually reason with the chimp. He's fucking.
Like
he's
you can't say.
Dude.
I don't know if the Rock would do it, and then say Shaq.
But Shaq's like, fucking huge. He's like 7 foot.
The Rock would fucking rip the Shaq in half.
Well, how tall is
the Rock? Now the Rock does have a nice singing voice as well, though.
He's
could probably lull it to
sleep.
The
Rock's like, he's like 5 or 6 inches shorter than Shaq.
He's right, also conventionally attractive.
But he's also like 3 feet wider than
now,
Shaq.
Now, I feel like you're biased here because he tweeted at you.
Just a little bit.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Me and him, we're good friends, you know?
I don't know why that factors in. Like, why are you bringing that up?
Yeah,
like, me and the Rock are, like, really good friends, but that's not...
Yeah.
It's not a situation you need to...
Yeah, I hear you.
I mean, we're getting bigger, but what
up.
About smaller? What about, Elijah Wood? How do you think he would fare against the chimp?
What about Shia LaBeouf?
Shia LaBeouf is like fucking... He's fairly strong, actually, for his size.
He's ironically not buff, but...
Ironically not buff.
Ironically not buff.
Nah, I'm not buff just because it'd be lame if I was buff, but, you know.
Well, his name in French is literally Shia the Muscly.
Oh, wow. Isn't it beef? Isn't boof like boof?
No, let's just assume it means muscly, okay? His name is the muscly.
Assume wildly.
Nobody knows French.
I know a little bit of
French.
French
is a made-up language.
Alright, you're going full English right now.
Full English.
Bloody French.
And they're bloody made-up words.
Oh my god, I just dropped 1,000 frames.
Wow.
Those are some spicy frames I just dropped, guys.
I'm taking serious damage.
Alright, I think we're back to normal now. I think it's good.
Well, who's this?
In the 1960s, these tests were repeated and the chimpanzee were found to have twice the strength of a human when it came to pulling weights. The reason for the higher strength seen in chimpanzees compared to humans are thought to come from longer skeletal muscle fibers that can generate twice the work output over a wider range of motion compared to skeletal muscle fibers.
Right, but they're comparing it to like a fucking 5'8" like regular build human and like not Arnold Schwarzenegger in his prime.
Arnold Schwarzenegger in his prime. Again, you've argued against yourself here, Sam, I feel, because the range of motion alone, Arnold Schwarzenegger was so conked out that I don't think he could do it.
He needed the range of motion for the action movies. I believe that he had a full range of motion.
Conan. Think about how fucking big he was then. Like
Conan Schwarzenegger against the chimp. Like, those studies can't They can't. The studies. It was never tested.
Then we need to.
We need to start the studies.
We need to get a charity fund.
Let them fight.
It needs to happen.
It's like when Jackie Moon fights the bear, but like, we take Arnold against his will, and he's not in his prime anymore. He's like old, and we make him fight like a young, strong chimp.
Yeah, but again, I feel like this is
and if he like does okay, then we can assume that in his prime he would have won.
Right, but that's extrapolation, Sam, and I don't believe in that. I believe you have to verify things, and I honestly think that.
Would you rather? So
what you're saying is,
would you rather a tough celebrity?
We need a time machine,
an actual fighter.
We need to bury a time capsule that says to our futures that dig it up that they have to do this. They have to recreate.
They have to go back in time.
Chat made a good point. Would you rather have a buff celebrity or an actual MMA fighter?
Fight a chimp.
Yeah. So, I mean, the fighter has, like, skills.
Yeah. Well, the technique plays a big role, but I feel like...
I don't know if technique does play a role against a chimp, you know what I mean? Like, maybe, like, punching technique, but, like, if you're going to argue that, like, all right, what about, like, a weightlifter? They're easily the strongest of our people.
Yeah,
they have no technique, you know?
What's a weightlifter gonna do unless the chimp, like, aligns himself like a fucking pulley, you know?
What about the Big Show? He could, like, chokeslam the chimp.
He could chokeslam the chimp, but he's not gonna catch the chimp, dude. He's a fucking weightlifter.
But the
he's
chimp will come to
shit.
Him. That's how chimps fight. They, like, jump.
Oh, yeah, the
you.
Chimp will come to him, but he'll jump, he'll swing around his neck, and then be on his back, and he'll start slinging
no,
shit
like,
everywhere.
Oh, it's the he'll Big blind Show! No, real Big Show to Nan! And he'll just grab the chimp off his back and fucking chokeslam it into the ground.
I mean, are we assuming that the chimp has knowledge that this is a fight from the get-go? Or is this... Oh! Oh! Let no! God!
Oh my god. Oh my god, are you dead? Did you die? Your
defenses
are nothing. Oh my god, no.
Well, they came up around me.
Crendor? There's only one way we can continue, you know what it is.
I can catch up.
No, you can't.
Hang the avatar.
We're level 21, you're not gonna catch up.
Fuck. That was not my fault.
Oh, I'm missing subs. EvilMonkey498 just subscribed. Thanks, EvilMonkey.
God, get him to fight the rock.
Swag.
Let's see.
Wait. I have an idea. I have an idea.
JM007890 dropped 200 bits and said, get an old chimp to fight an old Arnold cheer 200. Thank you, JM. And Darcy McOl just subscribed.
Work.
Thanks, Darcy McOl. Swag.
Okay. All right, so I guess Krendo, we're just going to have to kill ourselves.
Well,
I can catch up. I believe
that's the rules.
You.
If one of us dies, we all have to die.
Yeah, but we're in the cool thingy.
I know, and I don't know how we can progress.
Well,
voodoo. So scary. Alright, I made my hero. It's hardcore. It's seasonal. Let me just check if anyone's on that's got like a sweet little boosty. Listen, I feel like I sacrificed my life for that conversation.
Here's the thing.
100% worth it.
I'm gonna have to. I'm not gonna lie. I saw a chest.
Right.
I opened it, and
you killed
from
him.
Either side of Benji,
so you sprouted killed
him. Many a monster.
You killed
and
him.
They killed him.
I so could have hit two him. To escape, but I didn't think
I kill
time.
Him, or did the chest kill him?
Well, I believe it's a combination
a
of both.
And B.
Yeah. A and B. I mean, the chest was pretty tantalizing, but your own greed is what killed your friend.
I got, like, dank loot.
Someone said you should clue Sam in on bodybuilders. They aren't that strong, right? It's all form building, molding of muscle definition,
well,
not strength
there's significant overlap with strength and size, but you either go for one or the other and you sort of specialize more towards one. And strength, like the best power lifters that lift the heaviest weight tend to look kind of like chubby and fat because they have a huge amount of like fat for energy stores on top of huge amount of dense muscle.
Yeah.
But they're not like fucking tonked out bodybuilders, no.
Yeah, like
they're the
that
strongest.
On, like shows and stuff that do the like muscle.
Yeah, like
form
a lot of power lifters are kind of chubbed, but for good reason.
Yeah.
So
sense.
In an all-out war, chimps against humanity, we would lose.
Have you seen the documentary Planet vs. Apes? That's not what it's called.
Planet of the Apes.
Planet of the Apes. Planet versus apes. Just a story about apes trying to survive in the harsh environments of the world.
Yeah.
Today on Planet versus Apes, we go to the Amazon rainforest.
Goddamn.
Where Chibumwa and his friends are trying to get by day to day.
Well, I think it would be good.
Goddamn it.
It's versus apes. Alright, so what do we do?
I'm joining you guys. I can make this.
Alright.
I can break these cuffs.
I trust in
Don't...
you.
He's a witch doctor. I have a new ally
in Listen, I'm a witch doctor, so I can always be in safe distance away. It was a clever decision.
Apes.
Fuck.
I mean, yeah, if we could use our technology in the, and make like,
documentary
guns and shit.
Planet versus ape.
Wait, we gotta go this way.
Hello. I look more like Gollum now than I did now.
You do.
Especially in the darkness. Can you go over there into the darkness?
Wait, I thought you said...
Yeah.
Who said someone has a good Gollum voice?
Brandon, hold up.
Was it
like, he's over
Sam
there.
Has
there
a
is.
Good Gollum voice or Benji has a good Gollum voice?
Sam's got really good
Benji,
Gollum.
Benji, call to us. Come.
Sam, do you call him voice?
Crandall, do you see that over there in the shadows?
Yeah. The lighted bands!
Hello?
Hello?
Hey there, little guy.
Stay away!
Hey there, little guy, you okay?
What's your name? What's your name, little guy?
Thomas, hello. My name's
Thomas.
I'm a tax
I'm a scholar. I'm a scholar.
I'm a regal scholar. I'm a vacation to really bond with my inner instincts.
Yeah, I really wanted to dip my toes into nature, but I ended up just, you know, kind of getting shit-covered feet and stuff. I miss shoes.
You should probably stand back a bit, just in case.
Nah, I'm fine. Okay. You don't have to tell me what to do.
I hear that. JM007 dropping 100 more bits and says, but we have guns.
Yeah, but I'm saying without guns. Say that there was...
Tourney.
An electromagnetic pulse went off and destroyed every...
Because they're gunpowder.
Well, okay.
The year 2030.
When all guns are fitted with a calculator and that's how they work.
Yeah, they're fitted with a calculator and a phone. All guns have a built-in mobile phone because it's America.
Right. Yeah.
And without the
and
phone portion...
Your gun and your phone are now the same thing. And then an EMP blast goes off. Short circuits. Every phone gun... In America.
Is that what they call it? It doesn't sound like a catchy sound.
Simultaneously, the chimps break loose and go on a killing spree.
I still wanted to hear the Sam Gollum voice.
Yeah, you gotta do it, man. On the spot.
I can't.
Why not?
Like, I remember a specific time playing Chivalry with you, and I was just like, holy fuck, this is it.
But like, that was a couple of years ago when like the Gollum voice was hip and like I practiced it a lot.
And your voice has like matured a bit and
it, no, it definitely hasn't, but
I was trying to extend
it. I'm still a child, but I would need to like dust off the cobwebs before I came in and just dropped it on the bomb. You know? Anyone who has like a Gollum impression on the fly like that when you ask for it, you know they practice it in the mirror. You know they practice.
I practiced mine in me and Dodger's show thing. Because I did a Gollum voice for one of the guys. But now it's been like a month and a half since you recorded, so it's very out of place.
Fucking saved my life. Thank you.
And it's like, I can't even like pick it up right off the spot. I have to like work into it.
What it is Gollum is curling your throat and you have to speak like there's an air bubble in your throat.
Yeah. You like work.
Suddenly you're the expert.
Well, I know a little bit about it because I watched the making of and shit, and Andy Serkis is like really good at voice acting. I think he did Caesar in Planet vs. Apes as well, so like he played the main chimp, didn't he?
Yeah.
Andy Serkis. He's actually a really good actor.
Oddly enough, none of the people he plays are actually human.
Yeah, he does great. Well, he did a human guy in King Kong. Got you there, mate. You got eaten by a slug.
Checkmate.
Whoa.
Yeah, you just gotta like roll your tongue back.
Yeah.
Roll your tongue back?
Yeah. Yeah. You know how it is.
Vibrating, pulsating sounds.
Cause it's like, I hit like a meat wad, like a weird. Oh, gee. Well.
My frosty tomb.
Just recreate, come back. You'll be fine. Oh! Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god! I almost died there.
He was like, come back, you'll be fine. And then he was punching into a wall. And he had like 10 health left. Oh, that was good.
I'm on my way. I have been reborn.
Yeah, like, as I hit like a weird... It's like, I was trying to do it for our like little anime thing. And I kept doing meat wad, and I just kept being like, I can't get it. I can't.
It's the
like,
same pog to throw.
This is yeah. But I like kept doing the meat wad, and I'm like, this isn't it. I'm not doing it. And I was like, and then like after a while, it finally clicked, and I was like, yes.
From the sounds of things, it sounds like your throat, like your tongue isn't far back enough. Like you need to be like.
I think that's what it is.
Nearly.
Yeah, you're not getting the depth to it, but you're
nearly
getting,
like over
the gurgle.
I can't hit it.
Oh god. Are you okay?
No. He died that day.
Yeah, it's like that. It's like,
the precious. The precious. Precious. My precious. Stupid. Bad habits. Stupid.
No, you gotta get more energy. You gotta get more energy. Yeah, there you go.
Stupid fat hobbits.
Yeah, that's it.
You gotta really get the energy in.
I'm hearing things now.
Round of applause.
Wait, where are we going? This one.
Can you defend me?
No.
That guy Odavan just subscribed. Thanks, that guy Odavan. Swag.
Row, Scooby.
Whoa!
Hey.
Shit.
If you almost died, I definitely almost died. You like my little dangle flail? It's pretty good.
That dangle, though.
Oh my god, look at the way I walk.
Dude, you walk like an Egyptian. Oh, I gotta check the Lions Seahawks score real quick here, everybody. Just say, oh my god, Lions got shit.
Just walked straight up to him. I didn't realize. I completely forgot that I'm number one.
Alright, just remake, lunch. You'll come back, you'll be good. Don't worry.
That's okay. I don't think I will.
He'll be fine, just don't worry about it.
Just don't worry. Just smile.
We have a good strat, Krendo. I like hit one with exploding palm and then you kill him and he kills the rest.
Yeah.
I've just been like hitting the guy at the front and running away, because I can't even fucking fight them.
When do I get legendary? I have a new
ally in my group. Hey, a new ally.
Hey, it's me, guys. What's going on?
What's up?
Just coming at you with another video. Hello. This is my Witch Doctor build 2017. I've updated it.
Hey guys, DiabloTuber454 here, back with another Diablo video. I've updated my build to the latest meta build.
Oh, really?
Did you guys see any footage of the GTA RP thing?
Yeah, you should link to the cop thing, right?
Yeah, but did you just skip through the mod and see some of it?
I watched the dude getting sent to jail, but then I skipped later into the video and it's like...
See, look, this is the bit I hate. It's like one person is in an endless cycle of like misery.
It's okay, because every time I get born stronger, right?
You don't, though. I think you're dying quicker than you were before.
Listen,
nah,
son.
I think
I'm gonna name my demon hunter Illidan, alright? I won't be able to be defeated.
I guarantee that.
I'm not afraid.
Do you guys still play WoW?
I haven't played WoW in a while, actually.
I stopped playing WoW ages ago. Thing is, it's not... It just doesn't have, it just doesn't, it's not the same game, man. It's okay to pop on and fish and then play that and then
dude,
finish.
I like,
and then stop.
If Krendor and G.
No! He left me, man.
To be fair, he ran straight past me for you.
I mean,
luckily,
I had a lot of fun with
actually,
Legion.
No,
yeah,
well,
no, we had
me,
a lot of fun.
Me and Benji started on a vanilla server. Like a private
yeah,
one, and it was
fun.
Really fun, but
yeah.
The
problem
with it'd be more fun with more people.
Yeah
definitely that, and also I felt like I was worried because it wasn't like a very established server. They literally today I think they just launched the new PvP Nostarius one, and it's got like 6k people in it.
I did want to try it out actually.
I'll call myself.
I don't know if we can stream it though. Is
no,
it?
You can't
definitely cannot stream.
No.
That's
single
back.
Well, I mean, it's interesting to sort of see the differences in the game.
Yeah.
Plus the OG Dunmorar starting zone, that's the comfiest I've ever been in my life.
I still remember it.
Yeah, yeah. Like when you had to steal the tools from the trolls and shit.
Yeah.
It was just like, oh, and the music.
I remember all that.
Oh my god.
Now.
Krendo, get that front one with the handprint.
It's okay, I'm safe, guys. You can save me.
Oh, I'm freezing them all.
Yeah. Nice technique.
Yeah, really the only thing is like the grind.
Yeah, but like...
But if you're grinding with friends, it's alright, right? You do dungeons together and...
Yeah, because you're not really playing it so much for the endgame in vanilla. Yeah. It was more the world in vanilla. BC was endgame for me, and I stopped playing
it. Yeah, because I mean, like, back then you didn't really know what the endgame was, even.
Yeah, a lot of people were fucking turning up the raids in blues and greens and shit, because barely anyone had epics, so... Yeah. Everyone was. It was great.
I remember those days. Tell you what, I started playing January 1st.
What?
January 1st, 2005.
Yeah.
What I love about vanilla is us three rolling rogue and just decimating people.
All druids and just cat.
All druids, yeah.
But then, like, when we get in a serious situation, one of us turns into a bear, and one of us heals, and one of us just stays cat.
Druids were always fucking.
You could literally have like an entire raid of druids in vanilla.
Yeah, but they can't resurrect out of combat. They can't. They've got one like 10-minute cooldown res in vanilla and stuff. Rebirth, but they didn't have like a proper resurrect. I remember that. The good old days of game design.
Yeah.
It's like quirky, but it's cool. I like that almost.
Uh oh. Who's this? Uh oh. Warlord of Blood.
Where are you?
I'm just chilling there, Eric, man.
Oh. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah. All it's right, a shame, but like...
Focus on the weak one!
I'm helping the best I can. Yeah. If you let me die, I'll cry. Whoa. Four. Hey, guys.
See what I missed, stuff.
Hey.
Back again.
Lose damage from it.
Diablo Gamer here.
I'm like, Expert is legitimately, like, fucking terrifyingly painful.
It's pretty tough for us. Although, I feel like we've done harder before.
Maybe yeah, but no, I don't think we've done harder. Like, this place feels very hard.
It feels harder, yeah. I have Caltrops. No one's gonna chase me now.
That's pretty fun.
Invisible.
Oh, go disintegrate?
That's the beam, isn't it?
That's much better than the Ray of Frost.
Hold on, I think I need to turn... What's that option that turns on... cut down that lets you, like, do any skill you want?
It's in the options gameplay. Elective mode? It's on the right in, towards the middle.
Oh, I guess I did have it on. I just wasn't cycling through shit.
Yeah, you gotta cycle.
Gotta cycle
Ooh, yeah.
Oorah.
Oorah.
Aw, man. I love playing Halo campaign with my buddy. Growing up, that was the fucking shit, dude.
Before I played WoW, I played Halo 2 online a lot.
Oh, yeah. That was like my first console online.
Yeah, I played a lot of Halo 2.
Oh no, bench.
And then I remember because we were playing Halo 2 and my friend was like, yo dude, like this new game World of Warcraft's coming out. And I was like, oh neat.
This hit new game is coming out.
That
called
sounds
World of Warcraft.
Fun.
Dude, do you know how I found out about WoW? Mooncal, right? I went over his house.
Yeah.
And he was playing a Tauron. I don't know if it was Mooncal or not. And I sat next to him and we just sat there like we just sat there looking and absorbing things. We were like so absorbed with Stoneball Lake, which now is just like a puddle, right?
Yeah.
Dude, I did exactly the same thing with my friend. He was playing a Night Elf Hunter.
Oh, it tells us it was trippy as fuck.
By Teldrassil. I watched him get to level 10.
Why is my camera so low?
And then he was like, he turned to me and he was like, I'm not really into this game. Do you want to borrow it? And I was like, sure. And then he never got it back. Came in neck.
Yeah, and then you got, he became the neck bit. Playing World of Warcraft, that's what nerds do. Now, but at the time, WoW was considered the casual MMO.
Yeah.
It casualized everything.
And I mean, like, when I started, I was like third, 14? I think I was 14.
When was it? 2004, right?
Yeah, 2004. So I was the like end 10. Of 04.
So you were like 15, weren't you? 15, 16?
Was that 14 or 15? Probably 15.
Okay. Oh! Oh! Yeah, watch out! 15,
actually, I'm fine. No one can defeat me. I'm leaving Caltrops behind. Just trying to trip you up. Keep you on your toes, sir. Can this go through walls?
Oh my god, I just remembered. I played WoW for like the entire, like when it came out, I started in January, right? I played it the entire rest of the school year, and then when the end of summer hit, I switched to Star Wars Galaxies.
Oh, I never played that. I heard it was very RPG good. Like you could have housing.
I remember I was a Wookiee. I got a house. I liked my house. I got a speeder.
Sorry.
Some guy gave me
start
a weapon.
Again. You're a Wookiee? You can play as Wookiees?
Yeah, you can play as Wookiees. And then we had
why
a friend.
Why are we not playing that game right now?
We had a friend we went on raids and shit with. And then I quit and went back to WoW.
Yeah.
Was there a reason for your departure, or you just...
Oh, they patched it and made it shitty.
You could have been
right, SWG I gotta go back.
Grendel. Star Wars gamer Grendel. Star Wars Galaxy's Grendel.
You could have been me.
I'm losing my words,
can
you tell?
Star Wars gamer Grendel.
Fuck.
Star Wars gamer.
Star Wars gamer 454 here with another fantastic video for you guys.
Coming at you with all the hits, all the news, okay? It's gonna be good. I can't use my ability without my bow. Fuck. Well. Yeah, I remember. I played vanilla all the way through to Burning Crusade, but I was always shit at WoW. I enjoyed it a lot, but I was shit.
Dude, I remember being so bad at WoW that I was level like 29 and I joined like a small guild and they were like really cool. There's a bunch of like max levels, and there was a couple of lower levels, and they like took us places, helped us level and stuff. It was a really cool community, but then they like found out my playtime, and it was like less than some of them, and they were like, why are you not max level yet? And then they looked at my gear, and I think half of my gear was like cloth, and then half was leather, and I was just like equipping what looked cool, and they were like, oh my god, you're like
that sounds exactly
pathetic.
True. That sounds like
fucking pathetic.
The exact thing you
did. And I was like, oh. They're like, you should be max level by now. You should be wearing all leather. You get a bonus. I was like,
Benji
what?
Chat wants to know how old you are.
12. 12 tomorrow, actually. I'm not 12 till tomorrow. Just my big day.
I think we gotta go this way.
Nah, I'm 22. 22 and 23 in like a couple
I
months.
Spent so much time exploring the world of Warcraft that...
Oh, dude. Like... It was... The thing is, the community aspect was so much. I still, to this day, remember a dwarf hunter called Gigantic. He took me around... What's that place next to Dunmarar? I just
Loch Medan.
Yeah, Loch Medan. He took me around it, and he showed me all the trogs and everything. And then I kept meeting him while leveling up, and I knew him because he was a max level with that Arathi Mountain spear, that one that glowed blue. Yeah. And I always remember that. And then when I was playing BC, it was like I'd stopped talking to him since vanilla. And then when I was playing BC, I just saw him fly past me on an epic flying mount. I was like, wow, that's my boy.
The thing was like, WoW had such a small player base at that point.
Yeah, it had community. Yeah. Well, also the servers
like the
were so
servers
great.
Were like, yeah, very. So like, I remember when you PvP, like when Battlegrounds first came out.
You knew everybody.
Yeah, you knew everybody. It's like, oh, we're PvPing against these people again, or like this guy's in the thing. I remember we had one mage named like Sinrax or some shit, and he would just be like one of the top guys. He's like, yeah, going for High Warlord, and I'm like, dude, do you sleep? And he's like, I don't need sleep. He's probably dead now.
I don't need sleep.
But
I'll
tell you
sleep.
What, that guy got High Warlord. What a champion.
Wow. Proud of him. Don't know him. Proud of him.
Don't know him too much either, but you know
what? Well, back we go. All right, Benji, you gotta run.
No, I can stand and fight.
No, Benji, this
I've
guy just...
many caltrops on the ground, right? Never forget
this guy just randomly shoots mortars everywhere.
Look at this. Look at this. The sea of deception.
Whoa,
and spiking feet. All right, I've got this. I dodged it. Managed to dodge everything that came my way.
Hey, you're the highest level.
Do you think you're gonna survive this time?
I know I'm gonna survive. And don't you doubt it for a second. Yeah, my first, I told you guys my first, like, high level. My first creature was a goblin. A gnome, sorry. Fuck. But my first actual main in WoW was a hunter called Hunter Lordo. I thought that was a really good name.
Hunter Lordo.
Because I wanted Hunter Lord, but it was taken, so I took Hunter Lordo.
It's kind of great.
It's just kind of like one of those things that is painfully true and embarrassing.
Hunter Lordo.
Yeah, I love that hunter. He's a Night Elf hunter.
I just remember one of my main reasons for wanting to buy the game was I didn't buy it yet. My friends all had it. And they took the Zeppelin from Orgrimmar to Stranglethorn, and they were like, oh my god, we're fighting raptors randomly in the jungle. This is crazy. And I was like, I want to fight raptors.
Randomly spluttered around the jungle? That's what I want for me.
At what point, Krenner, did you realize it wasn't random? Was it instant?
It took a while.
Level 52.
Well, I mean, I feel like I just wanted to go on the adventures they were going, because I was like, oh shit, these are question mark raptors.
Dude, I remember I remember leveling up, and then like you get to like Stranglethorn Vale, and you start having legitimate beef with like the other faction, and there'll be like one guy is leveling the same zone as you, and you guys just duke it out for hours. No one even levels once. You don't get anything done.
Yeah.
You would like gank him, and he would gank you.
It's like that.
And then
in,
he would get his like high level fucking cousin, and then you would like get your friend.
It's like that in what's that place too? South Shore.
South Shore, yeah, was the Tarren Alliance Mil- town, and Tarren Mill was the Horde one in Hillsbradford Hills, I believe.
Yeah.
Hillsbrad. And before Battlegrounds released in vanilla, that's where all the PvP happened. People just natively went there. They picked out a zone before Battlegrounds released, and that was it. And it was just a fucking shit fest. I remember people saying, because I got to max level in vanilla, but only just. And I didn't really do any proper raiding. I just got pulled along to some things. But fuck me, I didn't understand it. Like, it didn't make any sense to me.
I just remember I saw, because like I hadn't seen any, nobody'd really raided yet. And I remember raids just started. And it was Molten Core. And some dude had the like tier 1 shaman shoulders and robe. Yeah? And I was like, that's so cool.
Yeah.
It's just like, I
remember seeing a night elf in like the iron feather breastplate and pants.
Yeah.
Like in a max level night elf in a bikini. Like, and I was like, that's the outfit from the cutscene at the start.
Yeah, that was some good shit.
Yeah, like
yeah, I always played Hunter.
The reason it's so like nostalgic and like that is because like it was such a new game to everybody and like everyone's playing it, but it was like so big.
I remember being like a kid,
giant,
and like one of my friend's big brothers, who was like at uni, had played it too, and he had like this warrior with like a disgusting like PvP mace. It was called like the Unstoppable Force.
Oh yeah, Unstoppable Force.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unstoppable Force.
And he was just like a beast. And every time we got like picked on by like people at our level or higher, he would like call his brother up on his phone, and then his brother would like log in and like come to our leveling zone and just like start wrecking kids with like this Unstoppable Force mace. And we would just like inspect him and like look at his mace and be like, man, he's so fucking cool. Like he's so strong and cool.
What a hero.
My mage.
I remember I made a warrior just to get the warrior PvP gear because I liked how it looked.
That's pretty
second,
much it.
Like thing I leveled up.
Wow. Warrior looked. I remember some guy tried to talk me into swapping accounts, trading accounts, and I actually nearly did it. And this was in, I think, Burning Crusade, because the warrior gear looked fucking sick. It had like molten faces on it on the shoulder pads. I was like amazed. But I'd never did it because I was too much of a puss. Probably for the best.
Yeah. Oh god.
Oh god, help me. There's enemies there. I can't save you now.
It took me forever to get my first mount, too.
Oh, I didn't get my level.
I never got one because I was a druid.
Dude,
I main druid from BC onwards and it was so fucking nice with flight form. Holy shit, but I think they patched it. But,
I started playing in vanilla and like literally I just cheetah formed and explored the entire world. Like without
I had hunter, so I guess I had aspect to the cheetah in vanilla.
Oh no, I'm dead. What? I'm dead.
You're fine.
Where are you?
Live, boy!
Oh my god, don't touch that book.
Guys, help me, there's a cultist down here.
Where?
Who's down here? Did you kill Eric?
I killed stuff.
Oh shit, Ben's.
Oh my god.
Ninja dodge. You can't compete with these movements. Alright, I'll lay counter off.
Tell you what, these movements, these aren't your ordinary movements. These aren't your dad's,
fast.
Your mom or dad's movements. These are high-tech modern movements.
Yeah, aspect of the pack was fucking sweet, because everyone was like, could you please turn off aspect of the pack?
It stunned me. Because
it would, like, stun people.
You're dazed.
Yeah,
you get dazed every time you take damage. It's like, oh! Sorry, that was intense. I accidentally put down a counter up instead of dodging, and then I used the dodge frames. But I made it. Ooh. Yeah, I remember, dude, I also remember my first thing I did was tame a nightsaber up near the lake in Teldrassil on my hunter, and I called it Luna, and I think I still have it on my hunter.
I tamed a crocodile and I named him Crocky.
Fuck. I named him Crocky.
Such a criminal thing to do.
And then people were like, well, you have a crocodile, it's a bad pet. And I was like, no.
What? You fuck?
No.
You're a bad pet.
Yeah. People trying to like shill the meta onto you and you're just like, crocodile, he's got many teeth.
He's very strong, boy.
I love that boy. Book of Lazarus is here, by the way.
Alright, good. Click it. Yeah.
No. I'm not clicking shit.
Oh no, I'm dead.
You're fine. Right,
you said
did
that
click
last
another
time.
Thing.
Ah! Don't click it. Don't.
They came downstairs. Grendel, come back. Save me. You've engaged red vets. I require additional pylons.
Oh boy. This guy is a spicy meatball.
He's chucking spicy meatballs your way.
Oh boy.
Uh-oh, spaghetti-o.
Oh god.
Help me. Please help me.
He's very strong. He's a very strong.
Oh yeah, that's Archbishop.
Yeah.
Okay, if I get hit once, he's dead, but I don't. I'm not gonna get hit. What he underestimates is how quickly I can loot these items off the ground.
My agility and speed.
Watch this. No chance.
I need more arcane power.
Think you can get me if I do a drive-by? That's later,
probably
nerd.
Not. Dude, nah. Archbishop? I think he's trying to summon Satan.
I think so. But he just summoned my counter-ups instead. I have four counter-ups at once. That's pretty good.
Power is not as great.
Oh!
Bench! Bench!
Oh, he teleported on me. Oh! Yo, he wants the dick, and I'm leaving. I'm getting out of here.
I need arcane power.
I require additional minerals. Oh, wait, was that like a legit dude?
Yeah.
I think so.
Dude, I unlocked the ability to use chakrams.
Nice.
Uh-oh.
Chakrams?
Chakrams. Yeah, no, they're chakrams. Don't I know from my American pronunciations of chakra and
the region. Hell yeah.
Sakura, my chakra's stronger.
I fucking love that shit growing up.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, oh, dude, Naruto was my gateway anime when I was a little baby boy. Actually, it was my gateway manga. I read it before I saw it. First thing I ever saw of anime and manga was a Naruto comic that was poorly translated. My mama brought it back. She's like, my friends, like, because I think it was a Japanese friend, my mum's friend, but she doesn't know her anymore. But yeah, her son liked it, and so we got cheap imported, like, terribly translated versions. I didn't know how to fucking say Naruto or anything for a long time. But then when me and my brother started watching it on like anime sites, it used up all our internet allowance and my dad got a big bill. So we were like, okay, we'll both watch on the same computer now. But unlimited internet is such a charm.
That's a
blessing.
Oh, I was in there.
I was outside watching you destroy my
It's the Dark Lord!
Dark Lord!
You can't destroy me if I'm too fast.
He ran out of there like a madman.
Ben, get the fuck out!
Save me,
he's
up there!
Diablo himself!
Diablo doesn't have shit on me.
He's dead. He's dead.
Damn shit on me.
Well. Alright, let's make another character real quick. I just fucking... I backflip directly into his slam on the ground.
What a goose.
Now I see that Heroes of the Storm Diablo is based on this Diablo.
Dude, no way.
Yeah,
Heroes
the OG Diablo.
Started that.
What?
Heroes of the Storm created Diablo, no doubt.
No doubter in my mind,
no
bro.
Doubter.
No doubter. I have a new ally in my group. Yeah, I think a lot of people pissed when they made like the chick
Alright, Krendo, you gotta like run. So that- Oh god, bitch!
No.
I made it! Wow, you're so tanky, Sam. Okay.
Krendo, not so much.
Yeah, no.
Okay. Oh god. That's the move from Heroes of the Storm!
I cast my mighty- Oh!
Oh my god, you're level 1.
I'm just slowly sauntering away. This is like Diablo though, because you couldn't run in Diablo, I don't think.
Yeah.
You only walk.
Woo, you got 5 levels from that.
Oh look, a cutscene.
It's a cutscene.
Wow, there's like 17 pixels.
And I counted 22.
Oh, I'm so sorry. What a goofy turd.
The Ark and Stone.
Thorin! He's not dead though. To be continued? Question mark.
He's gotta be dead. There's no way. It's not like he's gonna make a Diablo 2.
Turning to dust.
Skeleton now.
That looked like...
Hi, my name is Steve. Some people call me Diablo.
What's that face?
Like the cowbell guy.
No, I think he possesses him.
It looked like Christopher Walken.
Oh god.
Like legit.
In his younger days, back when he was a little bit saucy. Yeah, and then that guy impales himself. I remember there was like a traveler in Diablo 2 that became Diablo.
Dude.
Something to do.
Like if I played that as a kid, I'd be freaked out.
Why would you just shank that crystal into your
Because it's the power, he's becoming Diablo.
Yeah, like
Red Soul Shard, nice.
Had to do it.
You just had to.
It's like the power of the ring.
Yeah, it's so tantalizing. Okay, so this says can be inserted into helms. Periodically struggle for control, unleashing a fire that inflicts a bunch of percent of damage. Nice.
Woo.
That's pretty cool.
Is that it? We're done? We did it.
I think there was more.
No, it says press M to open the waypoint. That's it.
No, it was like something to do with the cow level.
Oh yeah, somebody did mention the cow level. Chat.
Cow level was an old staple.
We need your help.
Wait, isn't cow level just luck?
No, I think the cow level in Diablo 2 is... But I think this is like an ode to it, maybe? I'm not sure.
Did you guys get the mushroom? I didn't pick up...
Stranger believed he could suppress Diablo, which is why he put the crystal in his head. What, and like just get the power without the Diablo?
I'm not sure. Maybe he wanted to
the mushroom?
Him.
Where do we get the mushroom?
I remember like a robed guy in Diablo 2. Fucking awesome game.
If you put it in your helm, you get a great transmog. Huh.
Where's the mushroom? What floor is the mushroom on?
Guide me to the mushroom, please.
Oh, I have a mushroom.
Wait, you got the mushroom?
Is it just called like bad mushroom?
I have reusable parts.
I have a mushroom.
Let me go to the labyrinth. I'm
Does only one of us need the mushroom?
I don't know, Raggy.
Level 9 has the mushroom. Okay.
What?
The floor 9.
Oh. Time to go back then. Well, I don't think it'll drop for me.
I mean, I think you just pick it up.
New character, right?
I think you just pick it up off the ground.
Ah, okay. Well, I'll be teleporting onto you, Krendor.
You with your fancy movement skills. Fuck you, man.
You had them once.
In a different life. Now
only
I have
one
a,
of them
a flail.
The mushroom?
Yeah, I'm coming back to the
mushroom. Are you sure it's the right mushroom? Guys, what's the mushroom called? Also, I missed a sub of Bebop Pirate. Thank you, Bebop Pirate.
I'll go to town and check the mushroom.
Swag. Okay.
Check that mush, bro.
Dude, whenever I hear the name Bebop, I just think of the Ninja Turtles. guy.
I think of cowboy.
I got the rotten mushroom.
Oh.
Corrupt stench lingers around this mushroom as though it is more than mere rot. Mixing it in a cauldron will yield a special brew.
That sounds like sweet, what bro. We need. All right, let's just follow.
Yeah, seems like a little quest line for us to play through.
Yeah.
Insane. Nice little quest.
Maybe only one person.
Where's this cauldron they speak of?
They said it's in Tristram.
Bubble, boil in trouble. Well, we're in New Tristram. We need to go to.
Oh yeah, we gotta go to Tristram.
Yo, where that Tristram at? Everybody in the house, say some things. What was that song that you said that was like that the entire way? There was a song that you said the rapper was basically just like, yo, turn it up.
Oh yeah, that's for New Year's Eve. We were right. Like, and now we've got Jim Bob the Prophet for the sick rap. And he's like, yo, here we go, turn it up. Get the beat dropping. Here we go. Everybody clap your hands. Here we go. Get it going. Here we go. Get it. And I was like, all right, when's the song going to start? And he's like, thank you. And, just like, bye. And I was like,
I'm out.
What?
Fucking awful. Where'd you go, Sam?
I'm trying to find the cauldron.
It's in the chick's hut. It's over here somewhere.
Well, the houses are on fire, so what do you mean?
No, do you remember the chick's hut that was like destroyed? And you go down into the thing. Go, come to me. I'm at it. But there's enemies here. Oh okay. Fuck! Is it? Oh!
Hold on, I'm out of here.
He's dead. He's gone. He's dead.
At least I'm a beacon of light. You can TP on Crandall now, and you're there.
Wait, what?
All right.
Wait, this isn't it though. I thought we're supposed to go to like old Tristram.
I think this is Tristram, isn't it? I don't know. I think you're meant to go in the house though.
In here?
Yeah. Though there's a cauldron.
Oh yeah. Wait. You're right. You're right.
I'm right. Now to remake my character.
Wait, what? Where are you?
I'm dead as fuck.
Chat says down. No, it's wrong.
Oh, it's not the right wrong? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, chat says
I thought someone said the heart.
That cauldron just fell apart. Alright.
Okay.
I need to go back.
It's the old, tried my the best, old pixelated but I was fucking hut.
Wrong.
Look it up before you touch anything. There's a specific order. Or, y'all could tell us. There's 1,500 of you.
Yeah, guys, just tell us. It's easy. Everybody's going to say the same thing.
It's not that easy. Yeah, I 100% believe that to be true. Yo, where the fuck are you guys?
Not in the dark cellar.
Row, Scooby Dooby.
You ask where I am, but the question is, where are you?
Where are you? Yeah, playing those night elves, actually, I remember when we tried to do that. That was pretty cool, actually. Yeah. Me and Sam made two night elf druids.
I think it's here, Krenner.
We had a little bit of ERP right. And told yourself.
Yes.
Classic ERP, yes.
Alright, I got the witch's brew. This strange concoction has been sleeping for several years now.
Okay, so you got the witch's brew.
Oh, wait, is this the same hut, but in... It looks so similar.
Yeah, I think it's the old
one. It's the same hut, but in old Tristram.
Oh.
Wait, why'd you click the cow?
I just moved.
Chat said didn't click, don't click the cows.
Oh.
Cow order, middle, then left, then right.
Well. Okay, can we remake the game and will it still work?
Oh my god. That's not level one. What's this do?
This is a fucking ghost cow.
Go back to the village, they say.
Well, now I'm gonna touch the other cows. Fuck you. There you go. Feels good.
Alright, get out of there. Get out of there.
Listen, shit happens.
Oh, we have to remake the whole game, apparently.
Sometimes when you're solving a puzzle, you don't get the solution the first
time. Finish the brew thing first? I already have. I got the witch's brew. I already have it.
What is your deepest wish? I don't believe it.
SpineVin resubbing 2 months in a row. Hey, hey, 2 months, baby. Thanks, SpineVin. 1, 2. Swag.
Sometimes you just
all right, so I guess we just leave game. Prednor can like make a new one. Somehow.
Okay. Leave game. You need to take the brew to the village, wake everyone up, get the plan, make it, salvage it to get the map, then click the cows. So we have the brew, and all those people laying on the ground are,
idiots.
Well, they're the people from Tristram, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're all dead now.
Alright.
We have to make Wurt's leg.
Yeah, Wurt's leg is the item from Tristram.
Alright, Krenno, you need to make a new game.
Okay.
So, leave party then.
Alright, let me drink some more Yorkshire drink water.
And then, I'll invite... Bloop. Bloop. Okay.
I've been invited to a party, bro. Party in New Tristram!
Bro.
Let's go, everybody.
Alright, first we have to take the witch's bro to Farnum's corpse.
You just said witch's bro.
Witch's bro.
Take that, bro.
Take that, witch's bro.
Fuck it,
bro,
mate.
Bro, dude.
I have a new ally in my group.
Thanks.
Okay.
Night Frostblade,
well.
Just subscribed, Krendor.
Night Frostblade, thank you for just subscribing. Swag.
Alright.
We should check
now,
if the cows are reset.
But are the cows reset? That's the question.
That's the question we're all waiting to answer.
Excuse me, let me in.
Alright, so are the cows reset? I'm gonna say yes siree. I hope. I forgot.
They're up, I think.
Take the witch through to Farnum's corpse down from the entrance ball. Okay, Farnum's corpse.
Fine weapons. Oh, man.
She. Then take Drunkard's debt to Ogden's corpse. That's Griswold. Who's Ogden? There's Ogden.
Where are we going,
Eric?
To get Garda's lair. Take Garda's lair to Pepin's corpse.
Wasn't it down here? It was down here, I think.
Take the healer's prescription to Griswold's corpse.
Here it is.
Get the plan for Wurt's leg. Teleport back to town. Right,
so the cows are reset.
Okay.
Cows are reset, so we're good there.
Cows reset inbound.
So,
I have to go back to town.
Yeah, we gotta go back to town.
Speak to the blacksmith, and he learns Wurt's leg. Okay. Now I have to craft Wurt's leg, which costs 1,000,000 gold.
Does what? It now?
It costs them, costs 1,000,000 gold.
Oh, Eric, come to TP to me to get your plan, Eric. It drops on the floor for everyone.
Oh.
TP on me, get your plan.
So, what we can do is hit up one of our boys to get power leveled, and then get 1,000,000 gold, and then do the cow level.
Alright.
Yo, if you want to do that. Please. I would love a power level.
Zaltharion, are you here?
Anyone that's competent at a computer.
Oh, guys. Oh, man.
What's up?
Just caught one of my testicles between the thighs.
Ah! Crushed the ball.
Really, it's really taking the wind out of my sails.
Yeah.
Oh, deep breaths.
That's a wind knocker.
Oh, that's very uncomfortable.
Gives you a slight tinge of nausea.
Just strong a slight tinge of nausea.
Yeah, it's like creeping up
powerful
into my stomach.
Dude, I remember one time we played dodgeball, and I got hit right there. And I was just like, ugh! And then I was like, it's not that bad. And I went and sat down, and I was like, ugh!
You get like a couple seconds, and then like a waterfall. Like a dam breaking.
Yeah, it was...
Not good shit, man.
That was a... Nope.
Dash the worst.
No, that's a no-go, sir.
I'll take 2 bull crushes to go, please.
And one
there's people that like get up on that shit, isn't it? Like getting kicked and stuff in the nuts.
Yeah, which I have no idea.
That
how...
I will never. I will never.
I have no idea how
ever
you can do
try,
that.
Even.
I don't get how that can be a thing.
Because I've been hit in the nuts before, and I definitely didn't feel anything special.
I don't think
any
time I've ever been hit in the nuts, I've been like, yeah, that feels great. Well,
and I'll have another 2, please.
And 1 to go.
One for the journey home.
I have some eye goods
Oh fuck, I'm level one.
Zeltharion is sleepy. Fine, whatever, man.
Damn.
Let's get...
Don't worry. Don't worry, boys.
Alright.
So we stole loads of stuff and made hella bank? I guess so. Wait, I've got this? Oh, wow. They look awful. Fuck that. No,
alright,
I don't have.
I have a guy. He's gonna let me know, and then we're gonna join on him. Alright.
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 He's gonna make us powerful like never before.
I'm ready.
I'm gonna promote you to leader then.
Alright, we should try and get like helmets with sockets, I guess, and then put like a gem in there.
Wait, do I not have this thing anymore?
It's gonna matter. I don't think it's gonna matter.
Oh, I don't have it anymore. Fuck. Oh.
Even if you're a person that likes pain, that pain. Is like, I don't know. I don't get it. I can't understand. So I can't.
They did a study where they measured the pain of a woman giving birth, and then they measured the pain of a man being hit in the balls, and the pain of being hit in the balls like spiked significantly higher than the woman giving birth.
I heard that.
But like, obviously, it's like. Yeah, it's sustained. Like a momentary pain, and the woman's is sustained.
Yeah,
but like the amount of pain is significantly higher.
Now, I also heard that my accountant was like, "Oh, you have a gallstone," and he's like, "My mother had 9 children, and she said the worst pain of her life was gallstones."
Thanks.
And I was like, "All right, great."
After like the third kid, though, they're just sliding out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's science.
Like, someone saying they have 9 children.
It's a trauma path by that point, I think.
Yeah, someone saying they have 9 children, that's probably about the same as 3 children.
They're just hopping out of
the third one, it's like, it's
like
a fucking
wolf dinner,
slide.
It just flies out. You're like, god damn, another one.
Oh.
level 2 humanoid resubbing 5 months in a row. Thanks, level 2 humanoid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Swag. Fly at me, bro, resubbing 4 months in a row. Thanks, fly at me, bro. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Everyone feels pain differently. You can't quantify it. No, I mean you literally can scientifically quantify it. They have a way of measuring.
Well, it's the amount of receptors, generally the density of the area, that and that's sort of how you are set to experience it. But then how your brain interprets it can vary per person. But I don't think it varies that much. It's like when people say, "How do you know colors exist?" Like that we're seeing the same green. If you know, like I've seen a different green my whole life, so I wouldn't know the difference, right?
Yeah.
But how do we know what colorblindness is then? How do we know people are colorblind?
Well, they measure, the scientific measurement of pain is in DEL, which is unit of pain.
Yeah, there's ways to do it. Like, it applies for good feelings as well. Generally, it's how dense the area is how susceptible it is to feeling, because that's what feeling is. You have a certain amount of receptors in your fingertips.
Hellfish 1 resubbing 16 months in a row says, "Hey, thanks, Hellfish. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
So like, some people are like stoic as fuck, and they're just like, they don't care. They feel the pain, but they're just like,
yes, I
also feel pain, yes. And then they die with this horribly skeletal look on their face, but... just because they've been suffering in absolute agony for their whole lives.
That cut on your fingers infected,
dude, I'll
grandpa.
Get hit in the balls all day. Don't ask me to trade.